Super, super, super early morning. Only got an hour. So I gotta start early. Dawn patrol. See if we can get these perch early. Or croaker, whatever. Got a half moon up there. I'm gonna see if the darker swimbait start the morning. Took a little bit. Ooh, look at that. Phew. Yee-hee-hee. Nice perch. Nice. Nice. Look at that sunrise. Beautiful fish. Gosh, a beautiful fish. Look at that. See, comes in at about 12 and a quarter. Let's get this guy unpinned back in the water. Oh my gosh. Look how thick these are. Just chunks. Oh my God, they're massive. I've never, ever, ever seen this big a perch here. All right, dude, get gone. Thanks for playing. All right, that one was on the charcoal. Early morning, dark conditions, charcoal, 3-inch ripper with the chrome blue, millstone jig head, and the UV blast. Oh, that was beautiful. That was beautiful. Well, seriously, look at that sunrise. It doesn't get any better than that. I mean, my gosh. Oh, there's a bite. They're starting. They've woken up. They've woken up. They realize it's time to eat breakfast now. Here we go, back at it. That's just too good not to get a pick, good stills of. Oh my God. Okay, come on, fish. Where are you at? Let's go. Let's do it. Come on. I see it. I see it. Right out there in the flat. Oh, I see it. Come on. Right here. Okay, right here. Right here, come on. Come after it. Get it. Got it. Got it. Whatever it is, I got it. It's not fighting like a perch, not fighting like a croaker, it's fighting like a howie, but it's a perch. Another chunk perch on the stinger. Just go ahead and unpin this one. I want the halibut. Alright, thanks for playing, little guy. Probably about 10 inch. Whew. Alright. I want the halibut. I want that halibut. These perch are in here and it's skinny. Let's go, perch. Let's go, big halibut. Saw ya. Let's go. Do it. It's on. Another nice perch. Another nice Barlow perch. Thanks for playing. Just gonna get that halibut. Alright. 5 more minutes or so. That's all I got. Bigger fish. flash it up. Goodbye. It's an aggressive yellowfin croaker. Ultra aggressive yellowfin croaker. That'll do it. All right. That'll do it. Finish this day, or morning. It's hour and 2 minutes. I think is what it ended up being. All right. We'll end it that way. Nice. 13-inch yellowfin croaker. Let's get it cleaned up. There we go. Nice fish. All right, y'all. Again, every morning, 3-inch ripper. Gets it done. Thanks for watching. Oh, my. Evening session. Almost perfect looking conditions. Let's see if we can do anything here. Wow. Perfect. Let's see if they want to bite though. That's a whole different story. Gotta find them. In theory, they're in the same spot. Morning and evening, but you never know. Oh, there it is. On it. Don't rush it in. If it wants to run, let it run. Oh, there it goes. Almost. All right, let the water do its job. What do we got here? Oh my. That's it right there. That might be PB. Oh, I 100% promise you that's PB right there. 100% promise. 100% promise. Yes, sir. That is it. That is gonna be a new PB right there. Guaranteed. Let's see. Let's put the tape measure right now. No messing around. That is it. All the way at the tail, up to the front. Oh man. That is it. 14 and a half. Right. Again, that's it. On the 3-inch ripper, look, it just falls out right there. Perfect. 14. Actually, that's, right at the tail. Oh, it's so close. I'm calling that 15. That's 15-inch right there. Look at the size of this thing. Oh my gosh. That's it. 15-inch barred surf perch evening session. Heck yeah. Woo! right, little dude. Yeah, I'm still calling you little because you're still small, relatively, but take it off. Go for it. Yes.
Yes, 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 yes.
All right. Well, that's incredible. That's going to be tough to beat. Go from a 13 and a half inch as my PB to a 15. Wow. Oh, on this ripper. Told you, perfect conditions. I knew it would be out here. I can't even, I don't have any more adjectives or increased emotions I can give. That was it. That's what was supposed to happen. Oh my gosh. I don't get speechless very often. I'm quiet sometimes. Loud when I feel like I need to be, but that right there. I got nothing else to say. Oh my gosh! 15 inch barred surf perch. Orange County, California. Sunset. Evening bite. Wow. Wow. I'd like another fish or a couple more fish, but if I don't, so be it. Smaller little perch. You. Right. There we go. Look at that. Beautiful. Beautiful. All right, that one's probably about 10 inch. All right. Thanks for playing. You. Such a fun little fish. Unique fish. Gonzo. You. Just gotta find the right hole. They're here. They're all over. Just gotta find the right one. Right hole where they're holding, on the charcoal. Phew! I see, what am I stepping on? I hate stepping on things for sure, but. Right on!
Ow!
conditions are epic right now. Now if the fish can only bite. Let's go, fish. Let's go, fish. Nice big one again. Nice big barred surf perch again. I'm not gonna measure that one because it's, I know it's not 15. I'm not gonna get another 15. But look at that. There we go. Look at that. You. Probably another 13. Look at that right there. Perfect. Oh, awesome. Yay. Yes. Yes. You can call it a ripper of an evening session. Phew, there we go, buddy. Thank you for playing. I am absolutely not kidding. This is the most fun I have ever had surf fishing the last couple weeks. Well, ever since I started with these rippers, it's just been the best thing that's ever happened to me in the surf fishing. I mean, see the expensive ones, or at least not necessarily the expensive ones, but you see all the name brand ones from overseas, like Japan and whatnot, that have, that are ribbed, you know, this ribbed texture design with the really thin tail. I knew it had potential, I knew it would work in the salt water, but the plastic, very soft plastic that is used to make those, it's just too soft for these toothy fish that chase. So you know, all the tails are just biting off. It was gonna get too expensive. So that's why I tried making them in the plaster, but it just didn't have the detail I wanted it to have. Is having a trim too much or just whatever the case. I got these ripper molds from Barlow's and that changed everything for me. That was it. And again, if you're not, I mean, it's an expensive flipping sport. Yeah, again, I said sport. An expensive hobby. There you go. So if you don't have the funds to buy the molds or whatever, you can still, again, make them in plaster. They'll still work. It's just I wasn't getting what I wanted out of them. So let's say you don't do it in plaster, say you do it in the silicone. Probably get a better mold. But again, it costs more, and I was perfectly fine we could afford the mold, so I did it. But just make them. Make them and use them. You're gonna get bit. I promise you're gonna get bit. How long, how many casts it takes to get bit, I don't know. That's up to you. But you're gonna get bit on them. That's a promise. All right. I think that does it. I keep saying that, but I keep casting. I know the fish are here.